system started? How many type of motion are there? Can anybody? Type of motion. Did you see the automobiles, everybody? Did you see the automobiles? Yes, Ruthi, very good. Now, automobiles. See, when the automobile is traveling, once you give the accelerator, example, you take a cycle. When you take a cycle, if you are going on the cycle, riding the cycle, after pedaling 4 or 5 times, if you stop pedaling, will the cycle start going like that only or will it stop? After traveling certain distance, the cycle will come to rest. Why it will come to rest? Why it will come to rest means here there is a friction between. Okay. Now here, lack of motion. Now, Newton has given the laws of motion. Can you tell me what is the first law of motion? What do you call the first law of motion? First question is, did you learn the laws of motion anytime? Law of inertia. Shruti. CVK. Very good. Law of inertia. Very good. First one is Newton's first law is called law of inertia. Very good, Kumarika. Law of inertia. Now, Newton's first law. This law is given by Sir Isaac Newton. This explains about the inertia. Now, what is inertia? The tendency of a body to be in the state of rest or in a uniform motion until compelled by an external force or until acted upon by an external force. Is called inertia. That means a body which is at rest will be at rest. A body which is traveling with some velocity, uniform velocity, will be moving with uniform velocity until an external force acts on it to change its state of state. That means state of rest to state of motion or from state of motion to state of rest. This ability or this property or this tendency of an object, we call it as inertia. Inertia. In this one, the first one is, we have inertia of rest. Inertia of rest. Now, we have discussed. For this one, we are having an activity in your textbook. What the activity says? I told you, take a transparent glass. Transparent glass, water glass. Empty transparent water glass. Place it on a table. Take an empty transparent glass and place it on a table. Create a drawing sheet. You know, drawing sheet or any sheet paper. And place that paper on the surface of the glass. Place the paper or sheet, dry sheet on the top of the glass. On the dry sheet, place one coin. 5 rupee coin or just maybe 1 rupee coin. Place it on the table. Place it on the table. After that, you may apply a force from the front. Apply a force from the front or from the back. Apply a force. That means as you are playing the carrom board, like that you apply only on the drawing sheet or back, which is above the glass. If you push it, what happens? This drawing sheet moves forward and this pine falls in the glass. Why that pine is falling in the glass? This is here. This coin is at rest with respect to drawing sheet. And the force is being applied only on the drawing sheet. That's why by the right feet is going forward and the pine is falling in the glass. Yes. Here, this is happening. Here is the press. This is a press. This is a press. Therefore, we are applying the force only on the dry feet, not on the side. This is falling down. This is because of inertia of press. And if you observe the bus, if a luggage comes, the bus is traveling from one place to another place. We have some luggage, no? In the world now, we have the luggage. The luggage, if the luggage is light luggage, that means one bag or two bags, that we can allow in the bus. If the heavy luggage is there, we keep on the top of the bus. Now, what happens? The driver or the person who is riding the bus, or they will try to tie the luggage with rope. Why they will say to tie the rope to the luggage? Why? Because when the bus is moving, the luggage is also moving along with the velocity of the bus. Once the bus comes to rest, suddenly the luggage will not come. The driver will apply the brake on the bus. Here, the bus comes to rest, as the luggage is on the top of the bus, it still continues. Therefore, there is a chance of falling down. Here, if the luggage is stationary, if the bus is early taken off, then there is a chance of luggage falling back. That is the reason they are. Okay, now listen. This is our last inertia. Now, for this one, I will give one example. Suppose the marble is here. Suppose you are having a surface like this. Take this surface. Another triangle I am drawing. This is nothing but one right angle triangle and another right angle triangle. I am taking a marble or a ball, small ball, and placing the ball here. Just I will use. What happens? What happens? This ball rolls down like this. Slowly. It will come down. After coming here, what happens? Will it go up? Will it go up or it will be here only? I am placing the ball here. I am leaving it. Then tell me, is the ball coming down? Ball will come down or not? That is my question. I'm ready. This is a surface. Client 1, I will just play surface without any roughness. If I place the ball here, first case, if I place the ball here, then it is coming rolling by rubbing down, it is traveling up to here. With the help of scale, I measure the distance between this foot and final position of the ball where it is stopping. Let this be x 1 meter. That is all. Another time, I am looking in the height. Here it is the second time, I have placed the ball here. I am lifting. It will come down. It is traveling up to here. Again, I am taking scale and measure this distance. I got x 2 meters. When I compare these two, x 1 and x 2, I got like this. X 2 is less than x 1. X1 is greater than X2. Therefore, what I have observed is, if the height from the ground of the object is increasing, the speed of the ball is also increasing, and it is traveling more distance. As the height of the ball decreases, the speed of the ball is also decreasing, and it will travel less amount of distance on the same way. Same, I am doing the activity. Have taken a surface. This is a flat test. I have placed the ball here. First and left. The ball is coming down by rolling. And the ball is traveling up to here. Let the distance between this edge and this x1 meter. Here the plane surface is there. X1 meter. After that, I have removed the ball. I have taken some sand. You know sand? Okay, I have taken the fan and tipped the fan. This is the fan. I'm sprinkling the sand. First time I did not use sand. Second time I'm sprinkling the sand in. That means increasing the roughness of the plane. Roughness increasing it. Then again I will take the ball. I will place here on the same position, same height. Again I will. Now tell me, this ball will go up to this level or not? Yes.